that this was introduced as a regular course for all the students of 500 colleges, you know, 500 professional colleges, mainly the engineering, MBA, MCA, like that, in Uttar Pradesh Technical University from 2009 onward. So, 500 colleges covering almost around more than a lakh students per year. So 2009 it was introduced to them. And then 2011 it was introduced in Punjab Technical University, which includes another 325 engineering colleges. In fact, you put now, in 2009 it was 500 colleges, now it is more than 700 colleges. So 2011 onward it is introduced in PTU, Punjab Technical University. 2012 it is introduced in Himachal Pradesh Technical University and Andhra Pradesh has a technical university called Jawaharlal Nehru Technical University. So like that, you know, it has been introduced in around 6 universities, which is covering around 1,500 professional colleges and, you know, almost 2 lakhs students per year. So that is in the area of higher education. And the second part, which is, you know, this trying to think in terms of redesigning the whole curriculum on the basis of this understanding, has also somewhat, you know, started taking place, because most of these professional colleges who are teaching this course, they are now coming to realize that many of the concepts which they are passing on to the students are not falling in line with this, right? So some of the issues we discussed in between, you know, this, this economics you are teaching of unlimited wants and limited resource leading to deprivation, and this, you know, the limited needs and possibility of having more than what is required in nature leading to prosperity. Now they don't go together. So then you have to probably revisit it. Similarly, this issue of management by relationship and management by opposition or domination. So you'll have to revisit that. So this is being felt now. Okay. Some of the faculty members, you know, have started working on it as to how to redefine, you know, that approach. But the major part is still related to the first part, that is introducing it as a course, right, to all these students, you know, along with whatever they are studying, right? In the area of engineering or in the area of management or in the area of, you know, computer application and things like that, even pharmacy. So this is about the higher education. In the primary education and the secondary education, we have made some systematic effort in the, you know, in the state of Chhattisgarh, which, you know, coordinated from Raipur, which is the capital of this Chhattisgarh. So the syllabus for class first has been developed. The books have been written from first to eighth. Okay. In fact, the book from first to eighth, fifth has been published by the SCRT, the State Council for Education, Research and Training. Okay. And it is now being experimented with some 30 schools. And finally, it has to be implemented in 30,000 schools of Chhattisgarh. So Chhattisgarh, it is one of the small states in India, and it has got 30,000 schools. So that is the size we have to deal with. Right? So, but we have started, you know, with a kind of experimental basis with this 30 schools. So after this pilot project is run, then finally it will go for all 30,000 schools. So this is the kind of effort that is being made, you know, at the level of education and sanskar. And what we are trying to do now, at the, you know, the possibility which has opened up in Bhutan now, can, you know, we can see that I had already described that January 2012, that is this year, 6th to 8th January, was the first time when Thindaji came you know, to IIT Hyderabad, and he could, you know, kind of get some feel about this, you know, in the 3-day seminar. And then kind of group of people came for the workshop in IIT Kanpur in May 2012, and then Hyderabad, and then finally IIT Kanpur, and so on. So by now something like 70 people have come from here to India and have gone through this process of people's education program. Okay. And we recently had two small 3-day workshops here, Gheru College and CST. And then this month we are having 3 workshops, one at ACC as I had mentioned, one at Paro College of Education, and this 8-day workshop here. So that's the kind of effort which is made here in Bhutan, okay, in terms of people's education. But in this short period of 8 months, okay, there is a strong you know, need felt by those who have undergone this process that it must be made as a part of the education. So as far as the university is concerned, this Royal University of Bhutan is concerned, they have decided that it will be introduced in all the 10 colleges of Royal University of Bhutan from 2013 onwards. Okay. No, this is 2013? Yeah, 2013. August session onwards. So all the necessary formalities of passing it through the Academic Council and the Board of Studies and all is being done. So this will become a part of this higher education. But some deliberation is going on in regard to introducing it in the school education as well. So that's in the process. Nothing very concrete has been, you know, done to this state. And the ACC workshop, there was a lot of this feeling that it must be introduced to the non-formal education also, because you know, it must reach to the common people. And ACC has some awareness program also, other than this non-formal education. So they are kind of thinking in terms of bringing the secretary education for the next workshop in Hyderabad. Particularly Ashram Nitin is very enthusiastic about it. So she wants to bring her along, and then if the secretary technique, secretary education feels the need of it, then introduce it both at the level of education, the primary, secondary education, and also at the level of non-formal education. So that's in the process. And that is where we are. We thought that this workshop, we had kept particularly keeping in mind that, you know, if it has to be given a wider exposure, okay, then we must call the people related to education, you know, the higher education related to primary education, right? And particularly the people who are involved in the process of making the policy and implementation of it. So I think in that sense this workshop has been quite useful. The Minister of Education was also supposed to be in this workshop, but for some reason he has not been able to come. But I think quite a few people have come from different areas. Okay, these are the list of organizations. Almost 14 different organizations are here. Okay, they have been given this exposure. And what has been the outcome of this is what we will listen from you, right? What you have understood, what importance do you see of this, and how you, you know, intend to take it ahead is what we will listen from you, right, tomorrow. But our impression of whatever interaction has taken place in the last 7 days is that this message has been conveyed. Okay. This process of self-exploration has started in most of you, and you know, many of you have expressed the need that must be taken forward. Okay, and some of you have also, you know, kind of given your commitment, okay, that you would like to participate in this process in your own way, you know, whatever contribution you can make. So in that sense, from our side, we feel that the workshop has been successful and it has, you know, met with the purpose with which it was decided to have this workshop. But exactly what has been the your achievement and what is your feeling and what you would like to do in the future as a follow-up of this will be what we'll hear from you tomorrow.
भूटान की ये भूटान के टीचर्स तैयार हों और हमारी भागीदारी उनको तैयार करने की
या सो टू इम्पोर्टेंट थिंग्स विच वी हैव बीन डिस्कसिंग एंड विच इज स्लोली टेकिंग शेप इज दैट यू नो वी फील दैट यू नो ऑल दीज थिंग्स ओके मस्ट बी डन बाय द people of their society and their country and their nation. So our role, you know, we see is to prepare the resource person, okay, who can do it in their own place. So in the first session, first workshop in not the first, this is third workshop in July when Chindaji had come to Kanpur, we said that we must focus on preparing the resource person for Bhutan. So some 10-15 people at least must be prepared to do this work in Bhutan. And our role would be mainly to prepare them in the process. So after that, three people have already volunteered for it, who want to prepare themselves as the resource person. Right? Chindaji being one of them, then Dorje Wangchuk and the director of ILCS, the Lungthen Gyastoji. So three people have already volunteered. So what we are planning to do for this thing is that this is the first level of workshop, right? The first level introductory workshop we have. We have also the second level and the third level of workshop. Okay. Which is meant for those who have undergone this and, you know, have been reflecting upon this and certain level of, you know, understanding and the, you know, kind of practice have been reached. So with them we are planning the second level of workshop. So we have one in October in some in which some 20 some 10 people from Bhutan are coming, including Chindaji and Dorje Wangchuk from NITM, and then Lungthenji is coming. So that's one thing that we are in the process, and I think it will take some 2-3 years to, you know, get this 10-15 resource person prepared. The second thing which we thought after the discussion with the participants in the room of these people is that it must be translated in the native language to begin with in Jonkha, and then later on in other kind of native languages. So some effort is already made by some of the teachers in Gedu College in terms of translating just these, you know, presentations. First day presentation we had on this transformation from animal consciousness to human consciousness. So this translation was done and the presentation was made to the students, okay. And the response of the student was quite warm. So it gave a feeling that yes, this can be communicated, right, in Jonkha. Lungthenji, who is looking after this language and culture institute, is also keen. So we have one person from ILCS, Karna Renje, okay, who is also well versed with Hindi and Sanskrit, okay, and with Jonkha. So to kind of make some progress in this area. What we feel is that if we kind of translate it in the native language, it will be much easier, you know, for people to, you know, kind of understand and multiply. this burden of some kind of foreign language is very difficult to carry. Lot of energy is spent in the language itself. So that's second thing that we are, you know, thinking in terms of, and some effort has already been made in the process, and quite a few people are keen on doing this. And not only Jhumka, then later on we'll have to probably do the translation in some other 2-3 languages, because it seems that something like 4-5 languages are very common in different parts of the Bhutan. So that's what is also being planned and being processed. Anything else? And I think with this ACC workshop and this workshop, I think many more, you know, ideas are going to come. You know, many more people are also going to come forward. Okay. In this ACC workshop, quite a few people were there. The commissioner from Election Commission was there. Commissioner from the Civil Service, Pritam Pradhan, was also there. Then the registrar of the Royal Institute of Management, he was there. And so this registrar of Royal Institute of Management was also there. And of course people from this non-formal education, that is Ministry of Education, some of the counselors were there. So all of them strongly felt that something needs to be done to make it a part of their, you know, process. So all this has happened. Let's see what comes out of this. But my evaluation, or our evaluation of, you know, this team, is that in 8 months the progress has been much faster than we had expected. So that is about Bhutan. The estimate, you know, a very conservative estimate about how much time will it take if we go about with this. Okay. So I want to give a very conservative estimate to give you an idea of what is the time, order of time involved. So if you go by this process of people's education program, okay, our expected time is 100 years. Okay. And the basis of it is that we presume that it takes 10 years for a person to develop right understanding and right feeling and live with responsibility. Okay. So if that is, you know, the time taken, 10 years, and in next 10 years he can make 10 people have this right understanding and right feeling, then in 100 years 10 billion people will have the right understanding and right feeling. Okay. So this is 1,000 crore. So we have only 700 crore people. So all these 700 crore people can be taken care of in 100 years. If you go by this conservative estimate, that even if it is not introduced in education and sanskar, and we are making one-to-one efforts, and one person is taking 10 years to develop this right understanding and right feeling and live with that understanding, then it will take 100 years. And if you look at a civilization, right, 100 years is not a very long time. What do you think? For a civilization, 100 years is a very long time? No. So this is the conservative estimate of how much time it takes if we go by way of education, you know, people's education. But what we are finding, that is not, you know, where you will stop, right? Those who have some, you know, feel of this right understanding, okay, and right living, they immediately start thinking in terms of education and sanskar. And I, you know, told you about the example of Bhutan. So if that happens, it will take 20 to 50 years. Because then you are not multiplying 1 is to 10, right? You can multiply 1 is to 100. So instead it will take, you know, half the time. So 50 years, right? If you multiply faster, then it can even be done in 20 years. This 20 years is one generation, right? So your education, you know, and sanskar, if it is set right, then it will take, you know, roughly 20 years for one generation, you know, to go through this education and take the responsibility. So this is the time requirement of 20 to 50 years. And it is taken right at the level of society. If the policy decisions are made, right, in favor of this, then it may even be taken care of in 10 to 20 years. So that is the order of time, you know, scale, which will be required. So if we go by way of people's life, it may take 100 years. If we go by way of people's education, plus education, sanskar, it may take 20 to 50 years. And if you go by way of this, you know, policy decision at the level of society, then it might be realized in 10 to 20 years. But this is about the whole world. If you look at it at the level of Bhutan, for example, it must be some 10 to 30 years. So 10 to 30 years of time would be required. Because the number we have is very kind of small, very defined. Okay. And therefore to reach to this, through education and sanskar, is not going to be a very time taking. So this 10 to 30 years is the required time. So that's about the time estimate, right? Of how much time would it take for it to be there, you know, with the whole world, and how much time it might take for Bhutan. So this is an outline of the program of action which has to be done at the level of society. Okay. If there is any specific question on this, you can take it up. Otherwise, we'll, you know, further expand this. What we are doing in the name of education and SCAR program, that is introducing it as a course, you know, along with the other subjects. There we would like to discuss in more detail about, you know, what are going to be these steps. That is important for most of you, you know, who are coming from these colleges where this course is being introduced now. That we will discuss. But before that, let's see if there is any question on what we have discussed till now.
After hearing from you the groups that are likely to be covered and kind of preparation we are going through to introduce this element to Bhutanese society, I think we may have to start thinking about introducing in our local government organizations. That is the biggest one, 205 guilds, what we call it. And if the three volunteers like Dr. Pemet Lele, Dr. Do Jong Shu, and Lungten comes up, if some element of those can be considered during the training, because we are talking about through schools only, but if we have to achieve this 10 to 20 years time, we may have to rove in these communities which are very vital for us to disseminate this information to the public faster. This is my personal view. Second thing is most probably it must be heavy. If this news or some kind of information can be shared to the general public or to the educated floor in the form of magazine, in the form of a newsletter, that 5-6 colleges can come together and consolidate their ideas and decide on to inform. This is how we can bring in the people. This is basically to accelerate the process of getting the people on the main board. Otherwise there will be differences in understanding and implementation will be a difficult task. Attacking people on the educated cloud and leaving behind uneducated cloud. So we have putting on board, this is what I call. And coming back to your Chhattisgarh project on the primary level, what is the time frame like for experimentation? Because in Bhutan, we introduced in early 80s a reform called NEP. And we evaluated after 15-20 years, that came quite reversal to what we intended to. Because we have to make sure that whatever we do in the school is correct and properly evaluated in some appropriate intervals. Not having at the end of the day and saying, look, this was a mistake, now who we will go back to. So we do not want to fall into this kind of a situation in a trap. So I, for myself, wanted to know. And we implemented 50,000 as an experiment. What is the term like? What are kind of people are involved? And who prepares the materials? Evaluation, if it is left to the state government to do it. Basically, it will come to whole India, right? Your aim is that way. But experimentation is in one pocket. And what I feel is that if you try to nationalize the whole thing, right from north to the south, what would be the implication like in implementing? Because one sector will be way, one state will be way in advance. If it is accepted, the other nation or the state will be left behind. So I was thinking in a balanced way, if we think that after a certain period, if it is good enough, then it's better to implement to the rest of the country. And this is how we should draw this experience for implementation in Bhutan also.
Yeah. In this higher education, we are evaluating it almost on the semester basis. That is, this. At the end of the semester, what has been the observation change in the teacher? Because the first entity is the teacher, right? So what is the change in the behavior of the teacher? Change in his relationship with the students, right? Change in his, kind of sincerity with which he is teaching the course, and so on. So this, we are almost doing it on a semester basis. Then also changing the behavior of the attitude of the students. We have not done it with every student, but an overall kind of evaluation we are making. And also, change in the culture of the institute, the organization. That how it is reflecting in terms of the culture of the organization. So that kind of thing we are doing, for the higher education. For this primary and secondary education also, the targeted period is 1 year. So every 1 year, it is being evaluated. you know, the change in the behavior of the students and the change in the behavior of the teacher, and, you know, the discipline of the college, and the, even the academic, you know, performance in the college. So we think it can be done, you know, on a yearly basis. And then, you know,